Morning children, today I will start the last portion of the first chapters, event in sexual reproduction. In previous class we discussed all important portions of the sexual reproduction in plants. So even after attainment of maturity, all sexually reproducing organism exhibit events and processes that have resemble fundamental similarity. The events of sexual reproduction, though elaborate and complex, follow a regular sequences are pre-fertilization, fertilization and post-fertilization. First discuss pre-fertilization. These includes all the events of sexual reproduction prior to the fusion of gamete. The two main events of pre-fertilization are gametogenesis and gamete formation. Gametogenesis, it is clear for their name. Gamete means sexual unit, its formation. The process by which the formation of two different types of gametes is known as the gametogenesis. It involves formations of two gametes, that is male and female. In another word, we can say that gametogenesis is differentiated into the two different types of process. First is also known as spermatogenesis and second is also known as gametogenesis, like oogenesis. So formations of male gametes or male reproductive unit is called spermatogenesis, while formations of female gamete or female reproductive unit is called oogenesis. When male and female gametes are similar in appearance are called homogametes or isogametes. When the male and female gametes are morphologically dissimilar, they are called heterogametes, and male gametes is called sperm or anthrozoites, while female gametes called egg or ovum. It is clear for the figure given already in your book, NCRT book, figure number 1.5, you see. But first we call this is the gametes of similar size and equal appearance. They are morphologically similar to each other. That is best example of Chlamydomonas. That is the second example is human ovum. This is ovum of human and this is a sperm. There are the two different types of the gametes are also produced. So first gamete is also known as homogamete and second is also known as the heterogamete, in which both are morphologically different from each other. Gametes are always haploid. A haploid parent produces gametes by mitotic division, but diploid organism undergoes meiosis in a specialized cell. This is called meiotic. That means ki gamete mother cell to form gametes. At the end of meiosis, only one set of chromosomes get incorporated into each gamete. So gametes become haploid. Second point in pre-fertilization is known as gamete transfer. After gamete formations, male and female gametes must be physically brought together to facilitate fusion, that means fertilization. Male are always motile, whereas female static. In lower plants, both gametes are motile. Both gamete means that is male and female gametes. In simple plants like algae, bryophytes, pteridophytes, etc., water acts as the medium for gamete transfer. In seed plants, pollen grains are the carrier of male and female gametes. Male gametes and ovule have the egg. So, transfer of gamete takes place by the different plants in the different way. So first is water as the medium of transformation, and second the transfers of pollen from one parts to another parts. In angiosperms, pollen grains are the carrier of fertilization. Pollen grains, known as the male reproductive gametes, which also transfer anther to the stigma of the other plants. This process is known as pollination. So gamete transfers in angiosperms takes place by the process of pollination. Next events in sexual reproduction is known as fertilization. Fertilization means fusion of male and female gamete that result into formation of zygote. You know well already, zygote is a single cell diploid in nature. Fertilization takes place in two forms. One is also known as external and second is known as internal. External fertilization are those type of fertilization in which the fertilization takes place outside the body of the female and offsprings are not fully protected. But in internal fertilization, fertilization takes place inside the body of female organism in which offsprings are well protected. Third events in post-fertilization sexual reproduction is post-fertilization. Post-fertilization takes place after the formation of zygote. Zygote and second ho gaya embryogenesis. So first we discuss zygote development. Zygote development depends upon the life cycle and environment. Zygote ensure continuity of species between generation after generation. In algae and fungi, zygote develops a thick wall to resist desiccations and destroy. In haploantic life cycle, zygote undergoes meiosis to form form haploid organism. N is the symbol of haploid, whereas in diploantic life cycle organism divide mitotically to form diploid organism. 2N denoted as the diploid. So this is the symbolic second is also known as embryogenesis. Embryogenesis is the process by which formation of embryo takes place after zygote develops to form embryo, and this is known as embryogenesis. During embryogenesis, zygote undergoes cell divisions in the different manners. First by the mitotic to increase cell numbers, second by cell differentiation to form a specialized tissue. In animal, embryo development based on development of zygote outside or inside the body of the parent can be classified into oviparous and viviparous. In plants, after fertilization, zygote develops inside the ovule and form embryo. Fertilized ovule develops into seed and ovary develops into fruits. Seeds after dispersals get favorable conditions, germinate to produce new plants. The outer most protective covering of fruit is called pericarp or fruit wall. Here the Inside animal we see oviparous and viviparous. Viviparous are those type of organism which produce their young one in their same kind, but in oviparous organism lay their eggs fertilized or unfertilized manner, and all zygotes first of all covered by a calculus cell. Come out in incubation period and hatch out to develop new young. So your topics is finished today. You solve in-text questions in NCERT book, and some practice questions we have given for your practice. Thank you. Good afternoon, children. Today we will start the second chapter, sexual reproduction in flowering plant. First we discuss more about sexual reproduction. Sexual reproduction is formation of two different gametes and formation of zygote, you know well. Here we start the structure of flowering plants and the structure of a flower. Before discussion, we give you some introductions about the flower which facilitate the human beings and animals. Human beings have an intimate relationship with flower. Flowers are objects of aesthetic, ornamental, social, religious and cultural value. They have always been used as symbol for covering important human feelings such as love, affection, happiness, etc. In angiosperm, flower is known as reproductive parts which contain both male and female reproductive organs or reproductive units in them. So let us we see the structures of a flower. A flower has four holes. First, the outer most accessory organs and hole is known as calyx. Calyx is known as the bunch of green leafy structures present on the outer part of the flower. The single is known as sepal. It also provided the photosynthetic process in plants, help in manufacturing the food materials. Second hole is known as corolla. Corolla is attractive parts of the flower which attracts human beings as well as insects. The single of corolla is known as petal that helps the insects for pollination. The third hole is known as male reproductive organ, is known as androecium. There is the bunch of stamens present inside them, and the single is known as androecium is stamen. The fourth part, this is known as female reproductive part, is known as gynoecium. It contains three major parts. First is also known as stigma. Second is elongate part, is known as style. And third is the parts which is always known as and solen in nature, is known as ovary. These are the four holes of the flower. So let us we see the calyx and corolla is known as non-essential part of flower because they protect the reproductive organs during budding conditions. They protects from enemy, helps in pollination, and as well known as photosynthetic in nature. Second is androecium and gynoecium of flower, which is known as essential part of flower. It helps the plants in sexual reproduction. It bears both reproductive units like male gamete as well as the female gamete. So reproductive holes of flowers is androecium
and gynoecium. So let us we see one by one structures of androecium as well as gynoecium. So first discuss androecium. The single is known as stamen. Stamen consists of two parts. One is long and slender stalk like structures. These structures is known as filament, and upper where is the lobed structures is known as anther. The proximal end of the filament attached with the thalamus or the petal of the flower. So when we cut the transverse sections of the anther, and we see the different types of structures. The anther is four lobed structures having four microsporangium like this. This microsporangium contain pollen grains, and this is also known as pollen sac. And this line is also known as lines of dehiscence. So, like these structures, pollen spore mother cell, this is connective tissues. So, each lobe contains two theca. Each lobe contain two theca. So an anther contain four theca, four microsporangium. Each microsporangium contain pollen spore mother cell and develops to form pollen grains. Here we see the developments of pollen grain. Pollen grain or microsporangium. We see the clear cut structures, transverse sections of one theca. Four chambers, structures having nucleus inside them. Each cell contains nucleus. So many spore mother cells. Pollen spore mother cell. Endodermis. Middle layer, ectodermis, middle layer, endothecus, and this is the tapetum. The four layers and the walls of sporangium inside pollen spore mother cell present, which also develops and form the pollen grain. Each pollen develops, each pollen mother cell develops to form male gametophyte. So now we see development of pollen by pollen mother cell. Okay.